Proteins are made up of amino acids. Each amino acid has two functional groups, an amino group and a carboxyl group, which are attached to a central carbon atom named as C-alpha. The fourth position on C-alpha is occupied by a variable R group. Each amino acid has a different R group. The carboxyl group of one amino acid forms a strong covalent bond with the amino group of the second amino acid by leaving a water molecule. This bond is called as peptide bond. A dipeptide is formed by two amino acids with a peptide bond. A tripeptide is formed by three amino acids with two peptide bonds. And a tetrapeptide is formed by four amino acids with three peptide bonds. Similarly, the number of peptide bonds is always one less than the number of amino acids in a polypeptide chain. The peptide bond has a partial double bond character due to the resonance. The nitrogen donates its lone pair of electrons to the carbonyl carbon, and the C double bond O electrons are pushed towards oxygen atom. This results in a double bond formation between the nitrogen and the carbonyl carbon. And also, two charged species are formed, a positively charged nitrogen and a negatively charged oxygen. These two different forms interchange depending upon the environment. The double bond character makes the peptide bond rigid and planar. The peptide bond and two adjacent C-alpha carbon atoms are arranged in a single plane, which is called as peptide plane. This peptide plane is the basic repeating unit of a polypeptide chain. The rotation around the peptide bond, called as omega, which is closely restricted to 180 degrees in trans configuration and 0 degrees in cis configuration. The difference between these two configurations lies in the arrangement of C-alpha carbon atoms. In trans configuration, the C-alpha atoms are on the opposite side to the peptide bond, and in the cis configuration, they are on the same side. Cis configuration is rare due to steric clash, but there are few exceptions which we will see in the second part of this video. The architecture of a protein depends upon the orientation of the peptide planes with one another. The angles which determine the orientation of these peptide planes are called as dihedral angles. The torsion angle around the bond N to C alpha is called as phi, and the torsion angle around the bond C to C alpha is called as psi. To know more about dihedral angles and how to calculate a dihedral angle, watch the following video, and the link is also available in the description. Unlike omega, the dihedral angles phi and psi are not restricted to 180 degrees because they are the rotation angles of single bonds. And hence, they can freely rotate and facilitate protein molecules to attain different conformations. In the year 1963, an Indian scientist G. N. Ramachandran proposed a plot to describe the conformational changes allowed by the secondary structure elements of a protein molecule. This plot is known as Ramachandran plot, where phi values are plotted on x-axis and the psi values are plotted on y-axis. To this date, scientists use this plot to validate the protein structures. We will see in the next video what are the different secondary structural elements and what are their allowed torsion angles. And also, we will learn how to calculate the torsion angles of a peptide by using Pymol. Thank you for watching this video, and please do subscribe and be notified with the new videos. See you next time. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.